Hi, this is Dr. Fox, and let's talk about laryngeal neurovasculature. In this video, we'll discuss the arteries and nerves that serve the larynx, their specific targets, and their branches. In terms of the arteries that serve the larynx, things are relatively straightforward. We have a superior laryngeal artery and an inferior laryngeal artery. The superior laryngeal artery is a branch of the superior thyroid artery. That superior thyroid artery comes from external carotid. We can see the superior laryngeal artery branching from the superior thyroid artery here in this illustration, and it is piercing through the thyrohyoid membrane there, and it's accompanying the internal branch of the superior laryngeal nerve through this thyrohyoid membrane. The inferior laryngeal artery comes from the inferior thyroid artery. Inferior laryngeal artery branches from the inferior thyroid artery, and it accompanies the recurrent laryngeal nerve, moving superiorly along the tracheoesophageal groove, and it is going to serve the larynx from the inferior. So, superior and inferior laryngeal arteries, very straightforward. The vagus nerve is the sole innervator of the larynx, and it does so through two major sets of branches, the superior laryngeal nerves and the recurrent laryngeal nerves. The superior laryngeal nerve branches high from the vagus nerve, and it descends the neck, and it bifurcates into two branches. There is an external branch, which is the efferent to the cricothyroid muscle, which we can see there. And then there is the internal branch, which pierces through the thyrohyoid membrane, accompanying the superior laryngeal artery. And that internal branch does two things. First of all, it is the afferent of the mucosa, which are proximal or superior to the vocal folds. And secondly, it's the visceral motor, specifically secretomotor, to those mucosae, which are also proximal to the vocal folds, the same mucosa. So that internal branch is sensory and secretomotor to the mucosa proximal or superior to the vocal folds, whereas the external branch is efferent or motor to the cricothyroid muscle. I always remember this by, you know, I'm sensitive on the inside and I am muscular on the outside. Not really, but, you know, in perhaps an alternate universe. Okay, the other major branches of the vagus nerve which serve the larynx are the recurrent laryngeal nerves. And we'll see how the pathways of these recurrent laryngeal nerves vary from the right to the left. And that's a topic for another video. But suffice it to say that these recurrent laryngeal nerves have two major roles serving the larynx. The first is that they are the somatic motor or efferent to all intrinsic laryngeal muscles with the exception of cricothyroid. That's innervated by the external branch of the superior laryngeal nerve. Secondly, the recurrent laryngeal nerves are afferent or somatic sensory from and secretomotor to the mucosa distal to the vocal folds or inferior to the vocal folds. So those vocal folds are going to be a major landmark for the different innervation patterns of the internal branch of superior laryngeal nerve and the recurrent laryngeal nerve. So we've discussed the arteries which supply the larynx with blood, as well as the vagus nerve and its branches, which innervate the larynx. This is your summary slide. Thank you for your time.